all that God's been talking to us about amending our ways in Jeremiah. And God's been trying to tell us to turn from our wicked ways. So in Jeremiah, we see God was angry with the people because they wasn't their wicked ways. And in chapter 15, God, I'm going to start off, he said, "Then Jehovah said unto me, even if Moses and Samuel were standing before me, I would not show no favor toward these people. Drive them before me and let them go. And if they say to you, where should we go? You must say, this is what Jehovah says. Whoever is for deadly plague to death, whoever is for the sword to the sword, whoever is for the famine to the famine, whoever is for the captivity to the captivity. And I will appoint over them four counties, declares Jehovah." So in chapter 15, you guys could be seated. In chapter 15, God first said, we know that Moses and Samuel were the ones who would come to God and plead to God for the people. So God said in chapter 15, even if Moses and Samuel were to come to me and plead for these people, I would not give them favor. I would, he said, drive them before me. And then he began to say everything that he would do to the people as opposed to judgment. He said, "I will appoint over them four counties. Who will show compassion to you, Jerusalem? Who will sympathize with you, and who will stop to ask about your welfare? You have deserted me, declares Jehovah. You have turned your back on me, so I will stretch my hand against and destroy you. I'm tired of feeling pity for you, and I will know them with a fork in the gates of the land." So at this point, God was already declaring judgment on the people in Jerusalem. He was saying, you know, I don't care if Samuel comes to me or Moses comes to me to plead for you. I'm already done with these people. They turned their back on me. They wasn't listening to me when I was trying to plead with them so that this way I wouldn't cause judgment on them. These people just continue to walk in their wicked ways. They continue to constantly turn their back on me. They wouldn't turn from their wicked ways. So now I'm declaring judgment. Now I'm saying that enough is enough. And we see here, as he continued on, he said, verse 9, he said, I will give to the sword before their enemies, declared Jehovah. So he was saying that now everything that they had owned, he was going to give over to their enemies. Yes. He said, Jehovah said, "I will surely minister to you for good. I will surely intercede for you in the time of calamity and the time of distress. Can anyone break iron in pieces, iron from the north and copper? Your resources and treasures I will give as plunder, not for a price, but because of all your sins throughout all your territories, I will give them to your enemies to take a land you do not know." So there was a land already there, but these people didn't know of the land that Jehovah wanted to give to them. He wanted to give them this land, but he said, now that this land that you do not know of yet, because of your wicked ways and because of the things that you're doing, now I'm gonna turn this land over to your enemies because you have not hearkened unto my words. You have not listened when I was trying to tell you to turn from your ways. "For as fire being nigh to me as anger, it is burning against you. You know, O Jehovah." Now Jeremiah is pleading with Jehovah because Jeremiah wasn't walking in those ways. Jeremiah was trying to turn the people from their wicked ways. Jeremiah was trying to tell them, you know, don't walk that way. You know, listen, this is what Jehovah, judgment is coming, but the people wouldn't hearken. So now Jeremiah is saying here, Remember me, God, and turn your attention to me. Take vengeance on my persecutors for me. So at this point, Jeremiah was being persecuted because of the things he was saying. Because he stood up for the Lord and he didn't go with the people, he was being persecuted for the things he was saying. He was being persecuted because he didn't want to walk in the way the people were walking. Because he stood up for holiness, because he stood up for those things. Jeremiah was now being persecuted, being put in a place, and he's saying, God, remember me. Take vengeance, but I'm the persecutors for me. Don't let me perish because of your slowness to anger. Jeremiah said, "No, for your sake, I bear this reproach. Your words were found and I ate them." So as the words were being put out there, as God was telling the people to listen, Jeremiah listened and he said, "I ate these words that you put out. I ate them and they were sweet to me. Your word became to me as exaltation and the rejoicing of my heart." So Jeremiah didn't look down on these words. He didn't say, "Oh, okay," as the words were being preached, as it pricked his soul. He didn't become angry. He rejoiced in what God was saying. He rejoiced in the correction that God was giving him. Jeremiah rejoiced. He said, "I ate your words, Lord. I ate them. For your name has been called on me, O Jehovah, God of armies. I do not sit in the company of merrymakers and rejoice." So Jeremiah didn't sit in the company of those that were against God. He sat separate. He sat apart. He said, "God, I wasn't with them. I didn't sit with them." And he said, I do not sit in the company of them. Because your hand is upon me, I sit alone." So there's going to be a time that you're going to have to sit apart. You can't be around the people that are doing certain things. You can't sit with them. You have to separate yourself from those that are not of God. If they're not doing the things of God, if they're not sick, if they're not walking the walk and talking the talk, you have no business to be around them. These people, we are people of God. And God, Jeremiah said here, "I sat apart, God. I didn't do what the things that they were doing. For you have filled me with indignation. Why is my pain chronic?" So now in Jeremiah, the pain was chronic. Because as he's sitting apart, these people are making fun of him. These people are talking about him. These people are throwing shade on him. And he's standing for the God. In the midst of every adversary, Jeremiah stands and he said, "I don't care what they're doing. I'm still going to stand for you, God. I don't care if they talk about me. I'm still going to stand for you, God. I don't care what they do to me, God. I'm still going to stand for you." In the midst of everything that was going on, Jeremiah said, "I'm going to stand for you, God. It don't matter. It don't matter." So he said, "Why is my pain so chronic? My wound incurable. It refuses to be healed. Will you become to me like a deceptive water supply?" So God says that out of your belly, if you believe, if you have faith, shall flow rivers of living water. So now Jeremiah is questioning God. And he said, "Are you a deceptive water supply?" No. That's what Jeremiah went wrong. You can't question God. A deceptive water supply. His water supply is not deceptive. His water supply, if he said you believe on me and out of your bush will flow rivers of living water, then that's just what's going to be.
Amen.
Yes, Lord.
Bring it. That's
the water. So then Jeremiah, and this is where he had parted from God for a moment, because God said afterwards, if you return unto me. So at this point, Jeremiah left God even by saying, did you refuse to heal me, and will you become a deceptive water supply? He left God because God said, after, if you return back onto me, Jeremiah. So he left for that moment. So God is saying, you cannot speak words. You got to be careful in the midst of adversity and the things that are going on, what you say to God, what you're saying, because at that very moment, he left God. God said, to turn back onto me, okay? We have to be careful. In the midst of everything that's going on, then he said, "Then I will restore you, and you will stand before me." So he would have not gotten restored until he came back onto God and took back the words that he said. In the message, in the same thing, it says, I'll tell you now, give me one second. Jeremiah 15:15. In the message, this is how God answers me. "Take back those words and I'll take you back. Then you'll stand before me. Use words truly and well. Don't stoop to cheap whining. Then you'll speak for me." So he was telling Jeremiah, don't whine before me. Just because I put you in a place and you know this is the place I put you, don't whine after I put you there. Take back these words and then you can stand before me. Don't change your words to suit them. So he's saying, you know what I'm telling you to say, and it may be harsh, it may be rough, but don't change what I'm telling you to say so that it suits them. Stay and stand on my word and what I'm telling you alone. I'll turn you into a steel wall, a thick steel wall, impregnable. They'll attack you, but they won't put a dent in you. So yes, they'll come after you. Yes, they'll try to attack you for what you're trying to say because you're standing on God's word and you're saying what God wants you to say. But God is saying, don't worry about that. I'll be by your side. He said, I'll be by your side and I'm delivering God's decree. So I'm with you. As long as you know God is with you, Jehovah Shammah, he's always there. Yes. There's nothing. He's with you. He'll make sure. He'll take care of you as he's putting you to do the work. And we know that Papa is saying God is calling all of us to be Jeremiahs. So in your workplace, you have to be Jeremiah. In school, you're Jeremiah. When you're out in the street, you're the Jeremiahs. Try to lead the people back on, even in everything that you do. If you don't say much, your actions show a lot. And just by that alone, that could cause division in somebody not said just because you're not hanging out with the Joneses and you're not saying what the Joneses are saying and doing what they're doing, it still will cause a separation, and they see that. So we're called to be the light. And God is saying, I'm with you. In the midst of all the adversity that's going to come at you, I'm with you. Don't worry. I will be with you. Don't doubt me for a second. Don't say, God, you know, where are you? I'm there. He says, I'll deliver you from the grip of the wicked. I'll get you out of the clutch of the ruthless. So here God is, Jeremiah was pleading with God and saying, you know, remember me in the midst of everything that's going on. And God is saying, I'll be with you. So my topic for consideration would just be standing for God in the midst of adversity.